the second I was worried about the things I enjoyed and how to profit off of them, how to manifest more, how to take more from what I was already enjoying, the more that became clouded in the ideas of capitalism. And capitalism itself is a whole thing that is really hard for me to reconcile with, for a good reason. But because I was no longer attributing these things to parts of myself that I can enjoy and I can explore more however I decide to explore them more, and instead like seeing them as ways to gain, ways to make profit, ways to find security, it just, they lost their same inspiration. The inspiration came from the ways in which those things were a part of me. It has made it very hard to just kind of progress in any of them. None of this has been to say that it's bad to have a plan, it's bad to be smart about things. That's not what this conversation is about. I just think it's much more complex than that. The self is much more complex, and your self, your soul holds the key. Your soul holds the key to you. Like, why would your soul not be the map that you're supposed to follow? A lot of us have gotten so detached from ourselves in order to try and chase a secure life. And so now we need to define what we're really looking for in this life once we can put down the survival aspect of it. And a lot of people cannot do that yet. That's what I'm working towards. It's hot. It's too hot out here for this wig. Okay. It has been ages. It has been ages. It has been centuries. Wow. I'm actually really excited to be back. Isn't that crazy? I didn't know I'd be this excited. These past, really, it's been mostly the past couple months, but it's been the past couple years. I have learned a lot, and I'm here to share some of that with you, all right? It turns out I was stuck. I was so stuck. I was lost in this loop, this cycle of just absolute confusion. And that was scary for me, seeing myself as someone who's usually pretty self-aware, always reflective. For me to be so confused and so utterly lost, it was earth-shattering. Because I had no idea how to fix it. Like, I'm sitting here looking at this, okay, this is what I need to do. The problem was really that I got lost in so many different perspectives. I have the ability to see so many different perspectives and so many different ways in which things can be right and wrong, from different perspectives, from different circumstances, different backgrounds, like just opinions that people can have. I can see, I feel like I have the ability to understand so many different things. And because of that, I started to get lost in that. I started to get really lost in that. I couldn't even find my own perspective. I couldn't find my own opinion. I couldn't determine what was right to me because I started to see so deeply into other people's worlds and other people's opinions, other people's thoughts. And I had learned from my background that it's very easy for me to be wrong and for me to not be trustworthy with myself. So, I have been witnessing the effects of all of that for the past couple years. What that means is this. I have had a million different dreams. I've had a million different desires, a million different goals since I was little. And those things have been changing. And it started, I think, with the fact that everything I took enjoyment from, I was starting to wonder how I could profit. buddy, go about your day. Go about your day. Go about your day. Stop looking at me. The ground is hot. My butt's burning. My dreams are always very abstract and very, like, hard to accomplish type of dreams, at least to the world around me. I wanted to sing. I wanted to write music. I wanted to, or write lyrics. I wanted to write movies. I wanted to write books. I wanted to act. And these things, when you come from, when your background comes from a place of scarcity, it can feel like that's just a stupid decision and you need to go into a career for something else before you do that. And so I was trying to kind of balance those feelings. I was trying to learn what it meant to balance realisticness with my dreams, like ambition, balancing reality with the dream. And that in itself sounds kind of crazy. I was splitting myself in half, trying to give myself to the people who loved me and to do what they suggested, thinking it was just smarter, while also trying to hold on to what I felt from my dreams, trying to hold on to those desires. I had already kind of started to shut myself down the second I started focusing on money, the second I started focusing on scarcity. And so then it became about panic, because now that I feel scarce, I'm in survival mode. I am panicked and more concerned about trying to make sure everything's gonna be okay, make sure my family doesn't have to worry about me, make sure I can make money from these things that take true just inspiration to pursue. Inspiration, and like, because inspiration leads to drive, inspiration leads to motivation, and therein you can find discipline. But for me, I was just disciplining myself over and over again and kind of learning to shame myself for not having some kind of plan to make money, not being able to make money, or trying to be able to make money just any kind of way. When for me, and this was interesting learning this actually, because I've always felt like I cannot function doing anything I don't find some sort of pleasure in. And I was like confused as to why everybody could just do these jobs, do these decent paying jobs, and I can't seem to accomplish anything in those kind of jobs without breaking down. When I learned about my life, the human design chart? And my human design chart specifically states that I cannot succeed without doing something from a state of pleasure. If I'm doing it from obligation, no pleasure, it's a done deal. It won't work for me. That was extremely validating. So I'm like, it's written in the human design chart that people have studied, which, you know, if you agree with those kind of things, you don't. Just know I do here. We're spiritual over here. It was a huge relief because I'm like, oh, I'm not crazy. Oh, I'm not just being lazy. I'm not just being undisciplined. But still, even learning that, I didn't know how to progress. I didn't know how to move forward. And I stayed in this confusing loop of like, this should be happening, this should be happening. Everybody sees things like this. If you relax, then you can get this. If you do, like, everything was in my head. It was just all these ideas and perspectives swirling around, trying to dictate what I should do. And it was even this one perspective of like, if you feel like you should do it, like, it's not right. Or if you feel like you should, you're already not leading from a place of like where you need to be leading from. So then I feel pressure in that area and I don't know how to get back to like not leading from a place of should. It just was all these things of me trying to be self-aware and on top of like not being in touch with myself. That was really scary. Because it felt like I was just a concept up in the air that I was trying to get to follow a path. Because I could see how so many of these paths played out for other people. I could see what paths looked like in so many different ways. And I was just trying to throw myself onto a path that was trying to do the right thing. And no matter how many times somebody said, like, you cannot just do the right thing. There is no real right thing. there's only what's right for you. I couldn't, it just still would have me like, well, what is the right thing for me? I need to focus on the right thing. So even as I've pursued passions, I've just slowly lost any drive because I was so focused on how to monetize them. And I've been so focused on like how to attract more from them. Focused on waiting for inspiration, focused on the how to and the what I can be doing, which is not necessarily a bad thing, because thinking of what you can be doing, this, I don't like how this looks. But thinking of what you can be doing, like, you know, it's like, in a sense, like, there's still a sense of discipline that plays a role in that. And I think that can be good. But for me, it just felt like it was keeping me lost. And I didn't realize how stuck I was. I had no idea. I would make progress on certain accomplishments. I would accomplish goals and still be like, well, why is nothing happening for me still? And it's because I'm not doing this now. Now I need to be doing this. And it makes me feel relief because now I'm not surprised as to why I was so depressed throughout so much of my life, why I was having such a hard time during college. I live right by a school, so you might hear some kids. It's time for school to end. This is a bad time to do this. And it didn't occur to me until the last relationship I had before the one I'm in now. I was so concerned in the same way with being present in my relationships. I was having the same sort of issues. It's like, how do I do this? How do I show up like this? How do I handle this conflict right? How do I show up more? How do I show them their love more? And it would keep me in this constant state of paralysis where I very clearly didn't feel safe. The responsibility for those types of things lies with everyone involved, I believe. Sometimes it just happens that way. But it's also not necessarily about the responsibilities. It's about us learning how to be humans. And so for a long time, I didn't even feel like a person. And there was so much anger and pain that came out of this relationship. And it was the best I've ever done in a relationship. And that tore me to pieces because for someone who's like, I literally did the best possible thing I could do. That doesn't excuse any missteps, but at the same time, missteps should be allowed in a place where you're supposed to be. I was just terrified. And I didn't realize I was so unhappy and scared. So I realized I've been doing this thing with all my relationships where even though I know, like, if, you know, I have the knowledge to say that if it's not meant to be, it's not meant to be, like, think people serve their purposes and they leave, there still was something in me telling me that if I didn't contribute to this relationship how I was supposed to, if I didn't go in trying to make sure it lasted for as long as I could possibly make it last, then I failed. Then the relationship failed because of me. And I could not let that go. It was so frustrating to think that I was giving my all to make sure a relationship worked out, giving my all to make sure a dream panned out, and it would seem that I was never doing enough. And then when everything would blow up, when these things would fall apart, and when people would get angry at me for it, it just felt devastating because it's like, what else could I have possibly done? There are children looking at me. I was constantly trying so hard to work that I never found room to allow myself to feel like I was fulfilling my purpose just as it was when a relationship ended. Even if it ended erratically, we served our purposes and we did it. I was accepting it as a failure. Oh. I wish y'all could see that spider. It just dropped down past my phone. And sitting there realizing that, which I literally just did this morning, I could see the impact of all my relationships, my struggle, my absolute desire to try and keep them, to try and prove that I could make it work, that I could be good enough, that I could be better, that I could make people happy, that I could heal people the way I was supposed to. In trying to prove that, I stopped proving to myself that it was okay to just be human. It was okay to not have it all together and not have it, not follow the plan. And it's crazy because this sounds so simple. This sounds so obvious now. This is what everyone talks about. But me being who I am, I was like, yes, I know all those things. But if I'm living in those things, I was scared that if I'm living too much in the trust, then I'm not disciplining myself. That I'm not giving enough of myself. And I don't want to get so comfortable that I let things keep failing like this. Because things would blow up so terribly when it came to my relationships and my jobs or my dreams, that I was just like, it shouldn't go like this. There should be some aspect of peace to it. There should be something I'm doing to make it better. Otherwise, it's toxic. I'm doing something toxic. I'm doing something wrong. And the only thing I was doing was just holding so tightly to these ideals that I couldn't be human and that I couldn't give myself to anything truthfully. I couldn't allow for what was meant to come into my life because I was constantly chasing something that was not meant to go further. I have friendships that I just kept thinking, why didn't this work? Why didn't I? Like, what should I have done? I need to apologize. We could be friends again. We can do this again. And it's like, it's okay to say that it served its purpose, even with the screaming matches, if there were any, even with arguments, even with disagreements, even with someone utterly hating me, utterly not wanting to be around me, utterly feeling like I was the villain. We served our purposes. We did our things. And so when I started to apply this back to my dreams, I finally realized that I had been refusing to let go of a dream. I had been punishing myself for not accomplishing certain dreams the way I thought they were supposed to be accomplished. So there was like this whole thing about, here's a red ant. So I had this kind of whole thing where I was punishing myself for not being able to get to certain goals in the dreams that I had, instead of realizing how I had actually fulfilled the purpose of that dream and how it would propel me into my next dream. I was allowing myself to feel like a failure because there were people seeing me and being like, you don't appear to be doing anything. And they would be aggressively on me about succeeding, aggressively on me about how to try to do more, not seeing what I am doing and not being able to see because they're not living my life. And they will put this constant pressure on me that made me then feel terrible about myself and kept me in this loop of shame, to where I didn't have any aspiration to do anything else. I didn't have any drive to do anything else. I was just depressed. I was just stuck and I was just lost. And I was like hating myself, feeling like I was a failure because I couldn't accomplish these things they said I should accomplish. And that's hard because living in a space with people who are doing that, it's contributing to my energy in the home. And a lot of people take it personal that I'm someone who stays in my room a lot. A lot of people make fun of me for it. But the thing is, my energy doesn't feel safe. My heart doesn't feel safe otherwise. And so I've been having to try and learn how to build a sense of stability. Even being around the people closest to me who didn't seem to believe in the path that I was taking. And now at some points, like, it was, you know, it's necessary, like, and I don't want to shame them, because as a supporter, like, you want to feel like you're doing everything you can to support someone, even if that means telling them what they should be doing or trying to push them along the way you think they should be going. So I don't think that they did anything inherently wrong, but this stuff was clouding my energy and my spirit to where it kept me in just this shame. I was watching Sweet Magnolias, and that's funny because if I had a guilty pleasure, I would probably consider it like watching shows like that, like Sweet Magnolias, The Good Witch, like these gentle dramas that like not too much happens in, and everybody's like, they appear kind of like, it's a very slice of life kind of show. It's like a small town where everybody just loves each other. That's kind of like the focus, like a small town where they just love each other and do what they can for each other and learn to grow within themselves and for their communities. I really find peace in those shows, which is crazy for me because I used to find my peace watching horror games, and like one of my biggest games was called Corpse Party, and it's nothing but death and gore and misery. And so this is like a huge shift for me. When I was watching Sweet Magnolias, and something they were talking about was, well, spoiler alert for, you know, the last season, the third season, it was Maddie talking to her son Ty, and Ty quit the thing he's been doing all his life, the thing he's been good at. He decided he didn't want to do it anymore, and he told his family that. They were like, okay, well, you know, explore what you want to do. Like, you know, they were concerned and worried, but you know, as family is going to be. And it took a while, it took a little bit of time, but then he came back and he was like, I want to do baseball. I think I just wasn't appreciating it. Like, I think, I don't know, like he just was ready to come back. He was like, I know I'm good at it. His mother asked, she said, are you coming back to it? I want you to think about if you're coming back to it because, like, you know, you found love for an old dream again, or if you're coming back to it because it scares you to have let go of an old dream for a new one that you don't know yet. I'm the last person to think anyone should be scared to chase a new dream, even if their old one was going well, because they're listening to what's in their heart. I am a huge supporter of that. But for me, I never saw it that way. For me, it was just like, you're giving this up. You're giving up something that's good because you just don't want to do it anymore. Like, how dare you? How selfish and how greedy is that? Like, how undisciplined is that? When in reality, some of my dreams, the places I took them to, they served their purpose and propelled me further into a new dream that contributes in the way that it's supposed to contribute. And that kind of, I had to sit with that. I haven't allowed myself to have a new dream because of what I went to college for, me still trying to hold on to that, feeling like a failure to those I went to school with and to the people who supported me in going to school for it. I felt like a huge failure. I felt like it looked as though to everyone, even during school, that I just wasn't trying hard enough, that I just was being ridiculous about it. I could not fathom listening to myself. It was, again, all these other perspectives I was holding on to. I felt like I wanted a new dream every time something was just getting good, that I just wasn't sticking to it, and that is why I'm being punished, and that is why I cannot seem to get out of this loop of scarcity. When in reality, what I've done as far as my dreams, though it does not look like a thing to the people outside, it has propelled me in so many different ways. It has given me the ability to talk about things like this to everyone here. And I cannot fully explain the depths of what I understand now about myself and what I'm here to contribute. And there's still so much more I have to learn about it. In this moment, I can finally release and let go and say it. This doesn't look like what you think it's going to look like to my loved ones. And I appreciate their pushes, because some of their pushes have been meaningful. Some of their, not, they're all meaningful, but some of their pushes have pointed me in directions that I needed to go, have opened my eyes to certain things. But I realized first and foremost that trying to do what appeared to be right by them and by myself, right by myself because it was right by them, it kept me in place and it kept me not doing what I needed to do. Me having the brain that I have, having the capacity for empathy and perception that I have, I'm doing such amazing things, my mind contributes so much to those around me and so much to this world already. And that I am in a place, I am only 23. And it doesn't sound like that to me. It sounds like I'm, like in my head, I'm panicking when I say that. I'm like, I'm old, I'm getting too old for this. I can't, I should be making money right now. I should, like, the panic in me is intense. But I feel like that's unfair. For once, I can finally acknowledge that it is so unfair for me to keep holding myself to these standards, for me to not explore life the way I want to. And it's because of, like, this need to make money, I have shamed myself in every other aspect of my life. I can't really truly enjoy it or give to it the way I'm supposed to because I feel guilt. When this life was never about money. And I knew that ever since I was little, even with all the scarcity, even with the need for survival, even with the need to take care of my future generations, this was never about money. This world, this life, none of it. That I am here to bring forth happiness. I am here to bring forth the idea that there is more than survival. I am here to bring forth that kind of healing and to explore this life in every way that I desire so that I can continue producing this energy for the world around me. I see how what I do contributes. I see the magic of what I do. And it's scary because no one else can see that this is not tangible to anyone else but me, especially when I don't have money to show for it. And so trusting myself to do things when I feel like it, when my inspiration is there, trusting myself that I am disciplined when it is there, when I'm meant to be doing it, and forcing myself to do something in the name of discipline is not necessarily what's best for me, and in fact has hindered me a lot. I was writing a script and I would literally sit and stare at it repeatedly, on and off, trying to finish it, just getting on myself because I'm not finishing it. Slowly creating this narrative of shame in my consciousness, this narrative that I can't do it, this all this stuff, because I'm not listening to myself. My inspiration comes to me so frequently when I'm doing what I need to be doing with it, and not allowing these other perspectives to tell me what it's supposed to look like. This is terrifying to me because it feels like I'm pioneering something I do not understand, but I have to give all my trust to it. And I have to ask the people around me to trust it with me, to trust in me. It's terrifying. But this is who I am. And I'm ready to bring forth a world that thrives more on that, that understands that more than they understand trying to survive. So you will now see the new branding, the new rebranding of this channel and stuff. And it's funny because with the gaming channel, I kept getting on myself so bad about that because I was finally starting to pick up momentum on that. The second I started really picking up momentum on that, my computer malfunctioned and I could not get it to work. I couldn't get my computer fixed. I didn't have the money to get it fixed either. And I was more so intimidated by getting it fixed, by spending money to get it fixed. So there was all this stuff about that, but now I couldn't make gaming videos anymore. And I was like, this sucks. Why is it that when I feel like I'm picking up speed, like something stops me? I should be overcoming that. I should be working harder. I should be doing more. It's my fault. It's on me. When in reality, my gaming channel, what it was, has served its purpose. And it doesn't look like it because I did a few videos. I did a few little gaming videos, but my heart wasn't exactly there. And what it taught me was where my heart is supposed to go. And so right now, where I do wanna play games in the future, but I mostly want a gaming channel for like with friends. I think that's a part of my journey somewhat. This channel is actually really supposed to be about me talking to everyone else, me sharing the spiritual journey with everyone else, and talking on what I feel needs to be talked about. I've known for a very long time I had a voice that I was supposed to be using, and I would get scared because I would feel like I really didn't have anything to say, so that would hinder me. But when I felt the inspiration today, I acted on it. That is what I'm supposed to do. Is feel that inspiration and act on it. And not pressure it in any other way. But listen to myself and trust myself fully and divinely. Sorry. And so this is the beginning of a whole new situation. And I'm excited about all the things I have to share. I do have a lot to share. So yeah, thank you so much for listening. I feel nervous. I'm like, did I say all that I needed to say? But somebody took something from that message. It served its purpose. Thank you so much for watching and see you guys later. Share with your friends too. Share with your friends too if you feel called to. And also, you know, like, comment if you want. Share your thoughts. Let this be a community. I want this to be a community. And I'm grateful. I'm grateful to you all. I'm grateful to this world. I'm grateful. Okay, bye.